Hello, this is Reese, for it's always cold in San Francisco. Move your ass. And I'm here today to catch a spectacle that has brought out all kinds of crazy, which is the 100th annual San Francisco Beta Breakers. We'll be catching a glimpse of participants and see how this is. It's not some ordinary race. Since 1912, local enthusiasts and people around the world come to celebrate what it takes to run from the bay to the beach in a 12-kilometer run. So let's go talk to some people. I'm here right now where there are hundreds of people streaming along trying to struggle through the streets like cattle. I will ask some people about what they think. Hello, girl with a mustache. What's your name?
Catherine.
Girl around. How many times have you participated in Beta Breakers?
Every year!
You look like you would. Why are you running today in the 100th Beta Breakers? What is your purpose?
The chicks and the booze.
The chicks and, okay. What are you dressed up as?
Your mom.
Right now, let's go talk to somebody else since this guy's breath is stinking really bad. Right here, somebody that looks like they come out of the Folsom Street Fair. Hello, sir. What are you dressed up as here today? I wish I had a tackle right now. Okay.
This isn't a costume. I'm just looking for a bathroom.
Okay. I thought I saw one. I thought there was one next block. It seems like we have some participants throwing tortillas at us. I don't know if it's because I'm Latino or not. But anyways, so how many times have you participated in the Beta Breakers?
This is my fourth time.
Oh, okay. Well, that's all the time that we have for today.
My name is Vivian Morales for It's Always Cold in San Francisco's Tech Talk. Today I'll be talking about OLED technology, a new discovery about Albert Einstein, the upcoming Maker Faire, and a new kiosk at the Millbrae BART station. But first, let's talk about a revolution. There's buzz about technology that could change how we look at and see things forever, and that technology is OLED. OLED stands for Organic Light Emitting Diode. The diode is made of organic compounds that emit light when an electric charge is present. It has been observed as far back as the 1950s. So why does this all sound new? Production processes have been complicated, and there is still some setbacks about its functionality. Currently, it is used in certain television screens, computer monitors, and mobile devices like your PDA. OLED requires lower power consumption than regular screens, functions without a backlight, and has deep black levels. It also has a higher contrast, is thinner and lighter than any LCD. Take a look at this OLED Samsung product. Can you imagine that in your television? It's lightweight, flexible, and can be fabricated on plastic polymers. This will allow for more flexible screens, such as roll-up displays or even displays that are embedded on fabric or clothing. Imagine a piece of special plastic used on a screen that can be bent and rolled up without any damage. OLED has wider viewing angles than LCDs and plasma screens, and also improves brightness, which enables artificial contrast. Because the pixels are directly emit light, viewing angles can be approach up to 90 degrees, and images will still be perceived as lively and beautiful. OLED is still slow in mass production. A new breakthrough with OLED technology is that it is being used as a light source, which may replace Thomas Edison's light bulb. Maybe, who knows? Well, Philips, GE, Nanomarket, and Bay Area company Acuity Brands are now making light fixtures out of OLED. Acuity Brands and Nanomarkets has recently announced the production of more light fixtures. Imagine the possibilities. Next, we have an update on science and the theory of relativity. The gravity probe B, one of the longest running NASA projects, started in 1963, and just recently confirmed two predictions of Albert Einstein's general theory on relativity. Does it mean this? Probably not. The Gravity Probe B mission used an advanced gyroscope housed in a satellite to measure two aspects of Einstein's theory on gravity. These measurements confirm that it's known as the geodetic effect, an effect that involves the warping of space-time around a gravitational body such as a planet. According to a National Geographic report, the geodetic effect can be explained by thinking of Earth as a bowling ball and space-time as a trampoline. The gravity of the planet warps space-time like a bowling ball weighing down the middle of the trampoline. The second prediction confirmed is the concept of frame dragging. Frame dragging is the amount of the fabric of space-time that spinning objects pulls along with it. Sounds exciting yet? Now let's get local. The Peninsula Library System has introduced an automated kiosk that is currently set in this one location. They call this program Free to Read and Write. And an ingenious idea? That's for you to decide. Ideas. Well, if you have ideas and like tinkering, the 10th annual DIY or Bay Area Maker Fair is coming up. I'll be volunteering at the fair for both days, and you should come back, check it out. Well guys, my time is up, but here are three words I can leave you with. Sustain, create, and innovate. Thanks everyone, till next time.
Absolute crushing pain of being completely alone during the day hours? Do you feel like you just don't belong? Can't seem to make friends in the cafeteria? Ask your doctor about Geriatrixa to help you feel some semblance of normalcy today.